We kid around a lot, but tonight we've seen and heard some wonderful stories about how MPTF helps with health and financial needs. But as a caregiver, I can tell you firsthand, from firsthand experience, the social workers at MPTF do so much more. Let's visit with one wonderful family that MPTF was able to assist.
It was November 15th, 2011. We met at Shade Hotel in Manhattan Beach through mutual friends.
It was life-changing and, for me, the best thing that's ever happened to me, for sure. I was a prop maker for many years, building all the custom props for the set dressing department. A lot of stuff on the last Star Wars series was at Mandalorian.
Oh, yeah, a little show called Mandalorian. The party favorite.
Oh, Stepbrothers?
Yes.
the bunk beds.
Come on.
Hey, I never asked you. Yeah. Do you like guacamole?
Every Monday at the studio, they tested. And Joel came home this one Monday. He's like, you called me, you won't believe it. I have COVID. Joel was complaining of a severe, sudden headache. And that evening, had a massive stroke and remained in the hospital, in the ICU, for 50 days.
I remember the ambulance ride there and sitting out front, and that's it.
MPTF was founded really on the principles of social work, of being there for people in their darkest of times. We're there to catch the industry when larger systems fail.
Then it was figuring out income. We need to fill out paperwork for short-term disability, long-term disability. He's got a pension and all these benefits, and you've got to keep up with the bank of hours. And there was just all these things that I didn't know anything about. And so was introduced to Motion Picture Television Fund and a social worker, Naomi, who was assigned to our case.
I felt like my job, in addition to getting the benefits in place, was really to be there for Danielle. She's a force to be reckoned with. The vows, the marriage vows, the sickness and health, I mean, there isn't a more amazing testament than their relationship. But this would be overwhelming for even the strongest, most resilient person. And I really was a sounding board for her. That's it, you know? She knew she could call me when she needed to. She knew I was a safe space if she just needed to vent or let it out.
It was like a friend that I could count on, that I could turn to, that was helping me know what I needed to ask, what I needed to do. We haven't met her yet, but I look forward to meeting her and giving her a big hug.
With Joel and Danielle, it really wasn't about writing a check. It was about advocacy. And it was about pushing forward to get their disability benefits resolved so that they had money to pay their bills while Joel was recuperating.
It's you!
Oh, it's so great to meet you.
Thank you for all the help. Thank you.
Joel survived something life-changing, and for all intents and purposes, they didn't think he would walk out of there. And he did. And we're going to count our blessings.
Ditto.
Ditto.